As everyone continues preparing for Monday's ordination, the last few weeks have been one of transition for Bishop-elect Byrne as he left his parish in Maryland and headed north to New England.
Bishop-elect Byrne and I sat down right before Thanksgiving in his residence on Elliott Street in Springfield, his dog Zelly already making herself right at home.
Here she is, Miss Zelly. She's named after the mother of St. Thérèse of Lisieux, whom I have a great devotion to. And so St. Zelly was, she and her husband, Zelly and Louis Martin, were canonized by Pope Francis in 2015. And examples of, so I have in the back of my mind that I need to get a Louis. Since I've got a Zelly, I need a Louis, but I got to wait. I think she could use a little company, but...
She seems like a really sweet dog.
Oh, yeah, she's only 2.5, and she's a love.
It's been a whirlwind of a few months for the bishop-elect since he was named the 10th Bishop of Springfield October 14th. He told me what it was like to receive the phone call from the Pope's representative, Archbishop Christophe Pierre.
So I was... I was at the receptionist desk because she was off that day, and I was waiting for an appointment to come in, and all of a sudden a number came up on my cell phone, and I didn't recognize it, so I don't pick it up. And then it went to voicemail, and it was a 202 number, so then I picked it up, and it said, "Hello, Father Byrne, this is Archbishop Christophe Pierre." He's French, you know, which adds a little drama to the whole thing. And he said, "Please call me at your earliest convenience." I was like, oh. So I went into the youth room where I know nobody could hear me. And that's when he said, "The Holy Father would like to appoint you, is appointing you the Bishop of..." And then he paused and I was like, drum roll. And he said, "Springfield in Massachusetts," which I was excited about because I went to college up here. And so I am familiar with this area, and I've always loved Massachusetts, so I was delighted.
That's right. So you do have experience living in Massachusetts. You went to the College of the Holy Cross.
Exactly, yeah. Class of 86. I lived with 9 other guys in my in a house. It was more like a tenement. It was a horrible, dirty place. It wasn't because it was the building. It was because we were a bunch of college knuckleheads. And all of them were, it shows you the sort of cohesion. They'll all be at the ordination, all present there with their wives. So it'll be nice.
The 56-year-old bishop-elect and native of Washington, D.C., is the youngest of 8 children of Mary and the late Dr. William Byrne. As a youth, he attended Mater Dei School in Bethesda, Maryland, went on to Georgetown Prep in Rockville, Maryland, and then to Holy Cross, and finally the seminary, the Pontifical North American College in Rome. In 1994, he was ordained by Cardinal James A. Hickey. For the last 26 years, Bishop-elect Byrne has served as a parish priest. His most recent assignment, pastor of Our Lady of Mercy Parish in Potomac, Maryland. I connected on Zoom with 2 of the staff of Our Lady of Mercy. Parochial Vicar Father Joe Swick has served with Bishop-elect Byrne for the last 1.5 years.
What can we as a diocese look forward to in terms of how he will serve us?
I think you have to look forward to a great bishop, a father, a man who truly loves the priesthood. If I could tell you how many dinners we shared, and we'd be recounting stories of just ministry, and it would always end with, he'd call me Joe, say, "Joe, don't you just love the priesthood?" And I could see it always in his face, that genuine joy, that great happiness that he's always received as he's come to know the Lord through his ministry. And so I think what you have to look forward to is a man who genuinely loves the priesthood and loves priestly fraternity, and a man who will laugh along the way. Someone who certainly knows how to engage the other person, getting to know them, and having just a joyful time growing ever closer to the Lord.
Becca Hadley has been coordinator of youth ministry at Our Lady of Mercy Parish for the last 5 years.
You can tell he loves families. He baptized all 3 of my babies, and there are such joyful occasions, and I'm so glad that he was able to do that. Just the way he loves families and kids. I think that especially having the dog. You can tell that he just loves to have people drawn to him to be able to engage and share the joy of our Lord. So I've just really enjoyed working for him. And as far as youth ministry goes, he's just incredibly relatable, and he makes the gospel message appealing to all young people.
And making the gospel message relatable seems to be a passion for the bishop-elect. He is a popular columnist and YouTube personality with his series Five Things, highlighting five life hacks, prayer starters, or spiritual meditations to help people to grow closer to God and appreciate the small but vital things in life. The series was so popular that it's been developed into a book, Five Things with Father Bill, released in October by Loyola Press.
I feel like we're getting a celebrity as a bishop here between you having a YouTube channel and a book out.
I feel like you're talking to my mom.
I think that you have such a way of communicating with people. And what is your perception, your thought, what are your thoughts on using all of these channels of communication, and how important is that?
Oh, it's essential, and it's what the church has been doing since St. Paul pulled out a pen and started writing on papyrus, or whatever he wrote on, the letters, and then from those we see through the ages when all of a sudden Pius the, I think, 11th, started the Vatican radio station and started broadcasting around the world. And then Fulton Sheen, I don't put myself in any of those categories, Fulton Sheen or Pius, but we have to always pivot to see how people are getting their message.